When people observe others, they show a strong tendency to attribute behavior to personality factors rather than circumstances.
Hello. Yes, this is her. Yes, I do. Her name's Holly. She what? She fainted. Okay. No, I'll be right there. All right, thank you. Bye-bye. My daughter went to a matinee today, and I guess she fainted, so I'm going to go ahead and pick her up.
Okay.
If you guys can let yourself out.
Oh, sure.
Okay, because
sure.
I need to get over there.
Okay. Good luck.
Okay. Yeah.
If the theatergoers understood the situation this woman faced, they would have been less likely to attribute her behavior to a rude disposition. There is a tendency to underestimate situational influences and overestimate dispositional influences upon another's behavior. Social psychologists call this tendency the fundamental attribution error.
The fundamental attribution error refers to the fact that people, especially in our culture, make a systematic error, or at least show a systematic bias. We tend to be dispositionists or trait theorists. We tend to think that behavior is a result of the person. And in believing that, and in making that inference, we often undervalue or overlook the importance of the immediate social situation that's impinging on the actor.
There are four major factors that account for the fundamental attribution error. The first is perceptual. Most of the time, people tend to focus on the person or actor rather than the situation.
We're monitoring the actor's behavior. It's the thing we're focused on, and we're not focused on the situation. That's why when we're making attributions about our own behavior, we're less prone to the fundamental attribution error, because as actors, we're often focusing on the situation, not on ourselves. We can't even see ourselves as we act.
The second factor is motivational. People are motivated to hold others accountable for their actions.
If we feel that behavior is a result of situational factors, especially situational factors that are beyond our control, that enhances a sense that the world is unpredictable and even unfair, and we may not like that. So we may have some motivational reasons why we like to hold actors accountable.
The third factor is cultural. Western cultural beliefs emphasize individual responsibility, making people more prone to commit the fundamental attribution error.
We're a very individualistic culture, and it's kind of just woven through the whole warp and weft of our culture that actors are ultimately responsible for their fate. Each person has an individual relationship to God according to the Protestant ethic, and each person is ultimately accountable for what they do. More collectivist societies in East Asia, Japan, Korea, China, and the like, people are less prone to make the fundamental attribution error, or at very least, they're more prone to realize that what we call personality is very situation or context specific, that we are literally different people in different contexts and different roles.
Language factors also influence this phenomenon. It is simply less difficult to describe actions and personality traits than it is to describe situations.
You note that when we talk about traits, we can talk about person traits and describe the behavior in the same terms. So we can say, there's a brave person who did a brave act or a brave action, or a cowardly person who did something cowardly. the link is very direct. Notice how hard it is to describe that in situationist terms, to say, well, the person behaved the way they did because they were in a bravery-enhancing situation, or they were in an aggressiveness-perpetuating context, or they were in a generosity-provoking moment.
So how did you do on the exam?
I think I bombed it.
Really? I thought it was easy.
Well, I was out half the night, so I didn't really get a chance to study.
Well, if you keep on doing that, you might wind up like her.
Working two jobs to get through school isn't easy, but at least I only have one more month to go before I graduate.
Due to perceptual, motivational, cultural, and linguistic factors, people often commit the fundamental attribution error. Individuals too often underestimate the influence of the situation and too readily attribute someone's behavior to their disposition or personality.